نصحلا لمسغاها ونقول فهم اللغة اللي تدمع رماقي المحبوب جوارح يسباها حبو في دواخل الحشا الزقمير سباقي لا حول لي في مقضاها ما نصلي لنبي ركب الوراقي محمد عين الوجود طه
اللهم صلي على النبي ركب البراقي محمد عين الوجود طه صلي على النبي ركب البراقي محمد عين الوجود طه
حب الباح يزيد البشر في قلبي
ربي أمرنا بطاعته
في الميزان وساعة الحشر قاعد ندوز في شفاعته
قاعد ندوز في شفاعته
هذا هو أزكي المكي لحبيب الداقي من جاب القرآن والنباها هذا هو من سرى لنعمة حضر الأخلاقي وجاب التيسير وانزاها وعطاه الحوض واللواء والتاج والبراقي أمته هو طبيب داها ما صلي على النبي
ركب البراقي واحد من عين الوجود اللهم صلي على النبي ركب البراقي
واحد من عين الوجود
Yeah. أشرقوا
يا حبيبنا يا محمد
صلوا لي أشرقوا
هولوني يا بابا وهولوني يا سيدي
هولوني يا بابا هولوني يا سيدي
هولوني يا بابا وهولوني يا سيدي
هولوني يا بابا هولوني يا سيدي
هولوني يا سيدي حين شربوا من زمزم
هولوني يا سيدي حين شربوا من زمزم
عاشقين في رسول الله
هذه ساعة من ساعات الله يا الأرضيان في رسول الله
قوموا قوموا تمدحوا لله يا المحبين في رسول الله
هذه ساعة من ساعات الله يا الأرضيان في رسول الله قوموا قوموا تمدحوا لله يا العاشقين في رسول الله
جمالي
لا إله إلا الله
ويعول علي
لا إله إلا الله
لا يرى مع خيري
لا إله إلا الله
لو يذوق المنية
لا إله إلا الله
الله الله الله
لا إله
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome to a delightful evening full of sound, full of flavor, full of music. Now, you see these wonderful musicians here behind me? They are fasting because it's Ramadan today. You must know that. Or maybe some of you are already fast now in the audience. So I promise to them that I won't talk much about food. But I can't help myself, so just a little bit. Underneath me here, somewhere, there is a kitchen. And right now, spices are being blended, rice is mixed with meat, and all the smells, I don't know if they can come through the floor here, but I promise you, so some wonderful dishes are being prepared. So that's it, I'm done with food, promise. Now, I would like to talk about music, because there are many, many musicians here on stage, but I don't know how many of you know that there are actually two different musical styles here. One is the Andalusian style. You have to imagine it was developed in the courts of the Moorish kings, you know, so it's very sophisticated and high class. And the other style is the Gnaoua style. Now, the Gnaoua style comes from the roots of Africa, the heart of Africa. It was developed by Muslim slaves that they wanted to connect to their spiritual side, so they started to dance, to move, to create this trance, and out of this came this style of music. Just like in a story, you see. So once upon a time, there were two brothers. They were twins. They were living in a farm, but they were very, very different than one another, right? The first one, his name was Rauf. And for the moment he could walk, he would go into the fields with his father, roll around with the mud, you know, he would work all day, sometimes he would scratch himself, he wouldn't even notice that. So excited he was for the outside. Now, the other brother, his name was Shams ad-Din. And Shams, from the moment he'd learn how to read, he would go into his room and study. And after years, he became this wise young boy, and people would come to him and he would speak in this sophisticated language, and he would tell them exactly what they needed to know. But, you know, they grew up and they had wives, and one day their father died. So they had to work the land without him, and they did it together. The Rauf was working in the fields and making sure the cornfields grow and the fruit trees blossom. And Shams, he built a little school. And in that school, all the children would come and he would teach them how to read and write. He would share his knowledge. Now, one day, Rauf, there is always a one day in a story, you know? It has to come at a certain point. So Rauf, he came back home, but he didn't even manage to take off his boots, because his wife, immediately when she saw him, she said, "Sit down, I need to talk to you. Look, you are working very hard all day long in the fields, from morning till night, while your brother, what is he doing? He's sitting there in the classroom, in the air condition, and talking all day. Look, it's not fair. We have to do something about it. How about you just work on some of the land, and your brother can take care of his side? We have to split the land." Now, there's many ladies in the audience have noticed. So maybe you know that sixth sense of a woman, that kind of feeling women sometimes have inside, they feel exactly what is happening. Because exactly at that point, Shams ad-Din was coming back from school, and he didn't even manage to take his hat off when his wife sat him on a chair and told him, "What are we doing? Tell me. What are we doing? We can't even afford the books to the children in the school. We have to be more clever. Look, let's sell part of the land, and then we will be able to buy more stuff. We'll be able to prosper. Look, you have to go to your mother tomorrow and tell her that we have to split the land."
الخط قال بشارة ليك قريبة محبوبك.
أيام ترجع
ترصيني هذا غيبة وتوحش ما واسخي البراق ما علاش يا مالي هنا مالي يا مالي فاليا من مقصود
علاش يا مالي مالي لا للردى علاش يا مالي مالي لا للعدى وخلموني
ولا لا ويا لا لا
بالهوى ظلموني
ولا لا ويا لا لا
يا زادوا لاموني
ولا لا ويا لا لا
بالهوى ظلموني
لا لا ويا لا لا
علاش يا مالي مالي لا للعدى علاش يا مالي مالي لا للردى والله.
Thank you. رمضان نفوز بالمنى وتحققوا إلى السعادة والغنى وثقوا بوعد الله إذ فيه الهنا أوليس هذا القول قول إلهنا الصوم لي الصوم لي وأنا الذي أجزي به رمضان الخير يا البشير جئتنا بالنصر والفوز الكبير سال إله العرش أن يمحو العسير ثم يجني عن قريب كربلاء
Following day, the twins, they went straight to their mother. And they said, mother, we want to split the land. And the mother looked at them and said, what, you can't do that. Your father, he worked all his life to keep this land together. If you will split this land, that's not the only thing that's going to be split. Our family will be too. But you know, once the seed of doubt is planted, also farmers and some teachers that might sit here in the audience will tell you that it's very difficult to unroot the tree that grows out of it. So the mother, she looked at her children and she said, okay, we'll do it. We'll split the land. But just promise me one thing. Let's go, all of us, together as a family to the city. We'll travel there, be together, be united. We'll go to the marketplace. We'll enjoy the day. And also we'll go and pray at the mosque.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar,
Allahu Akbar.
Before, while we were playing music, they were playing music and I was talking, food was being prepared in the kitchen. Now I know already, in fact, that it already has been served. Yeah. And it's waiting for you there in the corridor. Maybe you noticed all these beautiful tables and the plates. And yeah. So there is one thing, you know, it's Ramadan today. And Ramadan, many things happen in Ramadan. Ramadan Kareem, by the way, to the people that are celebrating the fast. But one of the things is a challenge. There is a physical challenge there, right? People fast all day. And we thought, let's get the audience to be a part of it. So don't worry, we will serve you food, I promise. But we thought to challenge you. So how can we challenge you guys? We thought, let's limit the time of the meal to 25 minutes. Is that doable? Yes, definitely. You're Dutch, yeah. Dutch eat very quickly and it's finished. That's it. Yeah. No, but how will you know 25 minutes have passed? Well, I'll tell you. You will hear the sound of the raita. No chance in the world you're gonna miss that. Enjoy the meal. Now I'm really jealous, you know, because us poor artists, we have to wait until the end of the show. No, actually, that's not true. I just really wanted to say that. But What did you guys eat? Just a few dishes, throw it so I can get a sense of what did you eat? Harira, you ate harira as well. Huh? Did you eat chicken? Yeah? I'm Jewish myself, you know, if there is one thing we Jewish people are obsessed about is chicken. Now, I tell you, you know, I learned a lot from working with these guys, especially about Ramadan. Because I didn't know much about Ramadan when I started working with them, but I discovered that Ramadan is a time for contemplation. Yes. It's time for forgiveness, some people say. And also time where, especially actually, when families come together, united, in harmony. Well, not like the two brothers. Yeah? Yes, you remember they promised their mother that they will go together with her to the marketplace, to the city, to the mosque. Well, they did. But the moment they entered the bus, they made sure that their families together with them sit exactly on both opposite sides of that bus, putting their poor mother in between them. You know, and when a child would ask a question, the answer would be brief. And like this, the day was spent. They went to the marketplace, but making sure they walk with a fair distance. And when they entered the shop, they did it in turns. And when they went to buy spices, it wasn't the scent of friendship in the air. Eh? And even in the mosque, when they were kneeling down to pray, there was no spirit of harmony there. And like this, the day was spent. And they went into the bus station, tired, and they were about to board the bus when the mother looked at them and said, so who has the money? I don't have it here. No, I don't have. Before they knew it, they realized that the money was lost. and they had no way to pay the fee back home. And they started to argue, but the mother stopped them and said, look, I don't care whose fault it is, okay? You two are both adults, grown men. Now, you are going to sort it out. And I'm going to sit here with your lovely wives, with the children, under the shade. Go sort it out. Well, they had no choice, huh? And they went straight into the city, departing in opposite ways. And one brother walked through the city and he found himself in the middle of a field, right? And there was a land full of cornfields and all kinds of fields, and in the center of it was a tree. But it caught its attention because it was dying. And under that tree there was an old man and he was weeping. And Rauf, the brother, he couldn't help himself. He went straight to that old man and he said, old man, what's wrong? What happened to you? And the old man said, do you see that tree? This tree was here for centuries. It was always blossoming. And whenever it blossomed, all the fields around it, my fields, did as well. And I could pay and feed my family. But for 2 years, it's dead. And with it, all my fields died. And now, I'm going to need to sell my fields, and with that I will undo all the work my ancestors did. And Rafuk, he stopped for a moment and he said, can I have a look? Yeah, sure. And he went and he placed his hand on the tree and he listened. And then he kneeled down and he grabbed some soil with his hands and he smelled it and he asked, old man, tell me, were there any robbers in this area? Robbers? I don't know, yeah, like a few years ago, but they were caught and hanged many years back. Why are you asking? No, it doesn't matter. But tell me, and he looked and he saw the tree and then he saw the stream next to it and he said, give me a spade. And the old man gave him a spade. And he started to dig in the ground. The brother, he dug and he dug, moving his body to rhythms, humming. You know, it came straight from his gut. He loved the land so much. And he kept on digging and digging, sweating and sweating. And suddenly, bam, the sound of metal hitting wood could be heard. And before the old man knew it, the brother pulled out a chest. And he said, do you see this chest? It was buried here, just between the tree to the stream, next to the roots. That's why your tree was dead. And look, and he opened the chest, and it was full of gold. Eh? Now the old man, I don't need to tell you how delighted he was, right? And of course, he offered half of the money to our brother, but my brother looked at him and said, you know what? I don't need that money. I already got what I came for. But, you can give me a few coins just so I can pay my family ride back home.
Oh, رسول الله
singing for you. Sudali mini tara. Kamali mini tara. سوداني من طرا جابونا وجابونا من السودان جابونا Welcome to Morocco Welcome to Africa Oh kawari mini tara bam bam bara sudare mini tara bam bam bara kawari mini tara bam bam bara kawari mini tara Oh kawari mini tara bam bam bara sudare mini tara bam bam bara kawari mini tara bam bam bara kawari mini tara bam bam bara sudare mini tara bam bam Si de juia, kawali mini tara, jabuna u jabuna, Sudan jabuna, belkhana shi khaytona, Sudari mini tara, oh kawali mini tara, bam bam bara u Sudari mini tara, bam bam. We'll be right back.
in the meantime, yeah, the other brother, Shams, he found himself in the busiest part of the city. People were walking in and out, not paying any attention to one another, you know, like happens in cities, unfortunately. But he stopped in front of this courthouse because something caught his attention. There were four men wearing suits screaming at each other. In fact, three men were screaming at one man. And then they kept screaming, and suddenly they walked into the courthouse, leaving that man all devastated. And Shams came to him and says, do you need some help? Oh, you don't want to know? No, I want to know. Tell me. What happened? It's my cat. It's what? Your cat? Yeah, it's my cat. Look, you see these three people that walked into the courthouse? They were my brothers. And when our father died, we had to separate the land in four, and we did it. We separated it exactly to the same part. Each one of us got exactly what he needed, so it was equal, but there was one thing we couldn't separate, and that was the cat. So we decided that we will separate, not separate, but each one of us will get one of his legs, will own one of his legs. You know, and then one time this cat jumps off a tree and he breaks its leg, and whose leg is it? It's mine. Guess what? You know, and then I sit at home. Of course, I take care of the cat. I'm not like this. Don't see me. You know, I put a bandage around its leg, and I put it next to the fireplace so it can be warm. And then one day, one spark of fire goes to the bandage, and it goes on fire. And the cat starts to run around, burning down the curtains into the farm, the fields. Before we know it, everything is gone. And I don't have money, and they tell me it's my fault because it was my leg that caught the fire. And Shams thinks for a moment, and he says, let me help you. Can I be your lawyer? Yes, I don't have money to pay for a lawyer anyway. Don't worry. Let's go to the courthouse. So they go to the courthouse. And the moment they stand in front of the judge, Shams stands up, and he says, Your Honor, this is a disgrace. I must protest. I'm surprised you haven't noticed that yourself, in fact. I mean, look. Yeah, it's true, the cat was lying there, and it was the leg of my client that caught fire, but wasn't it the leg of my client that just wanted to sleep and stay and rest there, while it was the three other legs that decided that they had to run around everywhere and burn the entire farm? Not only he doesn't need to pay anything, in fact, it's the opposite. They need to pay him. So, you know what happened next, right? Yeah, and he got a lot of money. And when Shams was about to leave, of course, the client came to him and said, like, hey, can I offer you half of that money? And Shams, he said, no, thank you very much. I already got what I came for. You can give me a few coins so I can pay my family ride back home. Now, I tell you this. This time, when they were on the bus, they were sitting together. The children were talking with each other, the wives and the brothers were telling stories to each other. And when they arrived to the farm, they walked out and they started to walk towards the farm. And the mother was a bit slower. She saw how the children were walking together and the wives. And suddenly someone called her name. There was a man there. Madame, said the man, I am the lawyer. You invited me. Here is the contract. Look, all you need to do is sign here and the land will be split. And the mother, she looked at him, and she looked at her family going to the farm, seeing the two brothers kind of giving each other taps on the shoulder. And she took out that piece of paper, and she tore it, right, to tiny little pieces. But what about my fee? You know, a lawyer can never forget about his fee. I have that as well, she said. And out of her pocket, she pulled out the stolen wallet. Now I imagine that farm 40 years down the line, okay? And what I imagine is this. Big farm full of fields, olive trees, right, cornfields, wheat fields, and in the middle of that farm, there is a huge school. Not like the one that was there 40 years ago. It's really big and it's painted from the outside. And the children, well, they study at the school, but every break they run to the fields and they play football there. And the food from the field is being prepared for the children to eat. And I also imagine one woman bringing her two children for the first day at school. Now, one child is walking ahead of her, all excited, with his bag on his back, his eyes gleaming. And the other, she has to pull by his ear. And I imagine those two children sitting in the classroom. One looking out of the window, desperately wanting to go outside and run. And the other, well, he's writing and listening with big curious eyes. And I imagine their teacher, an old man by this time, looking at them with pride and smiling.
Oh, قيسك الزهر لوى قديما
من غير أرض ولا سماء
الله
from Morocco, and hope that about this kind of culture we forget all border and we think about humanity. One love, one heart for everybody. On the piano was Mr. Imad from Morocco. On the art token was Mr. Raphael. On the flute, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Marianne! From Tangier, on the canon, the start of Mr. Ahmed! From Morocco, on the vocals, is Mr. Dries Kara! On the gaita, you remember? Gaita.
And of course, Mehdi.
Yes. Thank you.